Hi everybody, welcome to the CSS3 course. In this video, I'm going to talk about the column setup for CSS. So before I discuss this issue, let me show you the web page on the right hand side. So I have some columns, okay, and the corresponding HTML file is shown on the left hand side. So I include a division called container, and in this division I have a heading, and then after the heading, I have some words. And I end the division here. And then I include another division which contains a lot of words. And I end the division here. Then the HTML file ends. So how can I change the paragraphs in the form of columns? I can make use of the CSS file, which is this one. So let me try to show both of them. Okay, for the container class, which is the first paragraph shown here, I can have some way to change the number of columns. Okay, I just used the column count attribute to help me change the number of columns. So for now, I set the columns to be 2. So in this case, I have 2 columns. Okay. So since the division includes the heading, the column will also include the heading. Okay. In addition to using column count, I can also have another way called column width. So when I use the column width attribute, when I set the value to be 50 pixels, I will simply set the width of each column to be 50 pixels. So when the words are too long, you can see that the words are overlapping each other across the columns. Okay. So in addition to using column count and column width, we can also have the shorthand form of including both the maximum column count and the minimum width in one row. How can I do this? I can do it this way. I can use the columns attribute. So the maximum number of columns is 3 and the minimum width of a column is 30 pixels. So in order to satisfy both conditions, the layout becomes this way. We have 3 columns and each width is at least 30 pixels. So in this layout, it can satisfy both conditions. How about the situation when I change the minimum width to be a larger value? Let me see. You see the effect is not changed because I constrained the number of maximum counts to be 3. Now when I change the minimum width to be 200 pixels, we see that the minimum width becomes 200 pixels and the number of columns becomes 2. 2 is allowed because I just set up the maximum number of columns and 2 is still allowed according to the requirement shown here. So that's why we can change the column effect in this way by means of the columns attribute. And in addition to adding the columns in this way, I can also create some vertical rules between the columns. So how can I do that? I can make use of the column rule attributes. Now I have already set up the column rule shown in the middle of the web page. Okay, so the color is orange, the style is dotted, and the width of the vertical rule is 10 pixels. And I can also set up the gap of the two columns to be 40 pixels. So this is a way of setting up the rule between two columns together with the column gap separation. Okay. In addition to using the column rule color, column rule style, and column rule width, I can just use one row to do all these three things. Now you can see that I override the column rule settings with one attribute called column rule shown here. So for the column rule attribute, I can set it to be green, dashed, and 5 pixels. So you can see such variations of the vertical rule shown on the web page. So you see the cascading property has helped me to override the settings for the column rule. Okay. I can also change the layout further. Okay, in this case, for each column, the text alignment is justified. Okay. Then I'm going to change the appearance of the heading. Now you see that the heading is placed inside the first column. Actually, it is not always necessary to show the title in this case. Let me go to the selector of the heading. Okay. When I set up the column span attribute to be all, it means that I can tell the element, which is H3 for now, to span all the columns. So you see it is placed out of the columns and it is placed on top of all the columns. So initially, the default value for column span attribute is none. So when I set it to none, I will have another situation. I just have the original situation. So we can say that the none value is the default value of the column span attribute. So let me change back to all. Okay, the title is put on top of the columns and it spans across all the columns. Okay. Now I want to show you another way of doing the column effect. Let me go to another paragraph, which is this one, whose class name is called Unbalanced Columns. So for the first article shown above, you see that the height of each column is quite balanced. So they have similar heights. But we don't always need to have this kind of settings. What does it mean by that? We can simply add some size for the division first. Now you see the height of the division is now 250 pixels. So that means I have some space below my words, okay? So in this case, when I do the column setup, I will have another effect that can be shown later. Now I want to have two columns. So when I set the column number to be 2, you see that the height of each column is quite balanced. So they have the same number of rows. But it is not the only way to set up the columns. We can make use of an attribute to help me change this appearance. Okay, when I set up the column fill attribute to be auto, you see that the first column is able to utilize the height of the division. So we can see that there are two more lines on the second column. So in this case, the setup of columns is no longer the balanced approach. So we can also say that the balanced value for the column fill attribute is the default value. So let me try it now. So when I set the column fill attribute to be balanced, you can see that the height of each column is already balanced. So let me change back. Now you see that the height of each column is no longer the same by using the auto value. So in this video, we have discussed so many topics about the columns. We can set the column width or the column count. We can also give the column gap separation. We can also set up the vertical rule that separates two columns. We can also put the elements across all the columns. And also we can set up the column fill attribute to have different heights for each column. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, Please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.